Hello, welcome back. In today's session, we are going to see how to create an GUI application using Sphinx. Remember in the previous session, we were discussing about how to create an GUI application using AWT. So in this session, we are going to talk about how to create an GUI application using the Sphinx framework. Now the steps almost remain the same. I have taught you the 6 steps for creating any GUI application. It's no different from the Sphinx as well. So the first thing is you have to create a frame, which we call as a container or a placeholder. Now once the placeholder is existing, then you have to start adding components into the frame. Then you have to set up the component properties. The component could be an button or a text box or a list, whatever you use them. And finally, you have to set up the property of the frame and set out the layout of the frame and finally make the frame visible. So these 6 steps were also the same for your AWT framework. Now, when you're talking of creating an GUI application using Sphinx, so you have to first create a frame, and creating a frame is very similar to what we did in AWT framework. You can either extend the frame class using inheritance, or you can create the object of the frame class in the main method. Now this is called this is one more method of actually creating the frame class. Now this is a step-by-step approach. We have already seen this in the previous session also. You need to create a frame. Now creating a frame can be done with 2 methods, as I have explained here. Then you have to add the frame components. So the frame components can be any of the components of the Sphinx. So remember that the Sphinx components are all prefixed with the character J. So you have a J label, J list, J table, J combo box, J button, etc. Then you have to set up the component properties. Then you have to set up the frame properties. And finally, you have to set up the layout for the frame, and you have to make the frame visible. So these are the 6 steps which you have to undertake in order to create a simple GUI application using Sphinx. Now let us directly jump into the code. Now the first program I'm showing here is in relevance to how to create a frame using an extension or inheritance. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to import javax.swing.star. So javax.swing is an package. If you remember, in the AWT we imported java.awt.star. So here we're importing javax.swing.star. Then I'm creating a class called swing.gui, which extends the JFrame. So remember that here the frame class is called as a JFrame class. I'm creating a constructor called swing.gui. So we know that the constructor is called as soon as an object is created, and the constructor would have the same name as that of the class. So the Sphinx GUI constructor will have a button B. So we are creating a button object called the B, which belongs to a class called JButton, and the button object would have the text called ClickMe. Then we are setting the properties of the button in respect to its XY coordinate position and the height and width of the button using the setBounce method. Then using the add function, we are adding the button to the frame. Then you are setting the size of the frame as 400 and 500, that is the width and height of the frame. Then you are setting the layout of the frame using the setLayout method. Right now, we are not worried about any specific type of layout. So we have passed a value called null, which means that we are not dealing with layout in this program. And finally, you are setting the visibility of the frame to true. So this is an simple class which we have designed. So in the main function, we are actually calling this particular class by saying new Sphinx GUI. Now there's one more way of calling, like creating an object. So that means what? When you say new Sphinx GUI, the instance is created of a Sphinx GUI class. Now you know that when an instance is created, the constructor is called, and all these properties, all these which have been written in the constructor, gets executed. So the output is something like this. You can see here the frame is created, you can see the button, okay. And but as I said earlier in the AWT application also, when I click on this button, nothing happens. That we have not done in this program still, because we are supposed to learn what is event handling in Java. Now What I want to show here is the comparison between the output we got from AWT and the output we got from Swing. So you can see that the AWT output is on the right hand side and the Swing output is on the left hand side. Okay, now you can see the difference of buttons, okay, the look and feel of the button. This is what I was trying to tell you, the difference between the Swing and AWT. AWT is platform dependent, whereas Swing is platform independent. So now you know what, how the output differs when you actually write an application using Swing or in AWT. Now one more method of creating an GUI application is actually creating an object of a frame class in the main method itself. So very straightforward program. I'm importing javax.swing.star. So you know that javax.swing is an package, and dot star means I'm importing all the classes of that particular package. Now you have the main method class. In the main method class, I'm creating an instance of the frame object called f. So you can see that you have jframe, f is equal to new jframe. So f is an frame object of the class jframe, and you are creating in a button object called b, which is of the jbutton class. So you are passing this value called click me. So basically jbutton is a constructor, which means that you are passing the value click me, means that click me would be actually displayed on the button. Then you are setting the boundaries of the button, that is 130 by 100, that is the x and y coordinates and the width and height. Then using the frame object, you are adding the button to the frame, f dot add b. Then using the frame object, you are setting the size of the frame, that is 400 and 500, and you are setting the visibility to true. So this also will give me the same output as before. So there is no difference. The only thing is the programmatical style is different. Actually, in the first I use inheritance, in the second I am actually creating an object of the frame class in the main method itself. Okay, so now let us actually get into Eclipse and see how this actual program is executed. This is the program where you are creating a class called Swing GUI, which extends JFrame. So you are using the concept of inheritance here. So let me run this program. So when I run this program, you are getting an output here. Now you can see that a frame is created. So you have the button called, you have a button here, this is a J button, and on that you have click me. So observe that when I click on this button, nothing happens. You can also move the frame. Okay, so this is one output what I basically get. Okay, thank you for watching this particular session. So I will see you in the next session, where I'm going to discuss about the event delegation model. Till then, take care. Bye bye.